Pocoyo and Ellie and Pato.
Hi!
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening?
Yay!
Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Ellie out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Ellie, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Ellie, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh my, your balloons now. Phew. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it?
Aha!
It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready?
3, 2, 1, blast off!
Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. See you soon.
Pocoyo?
Hello.
Oh. What's this?
Duh.
Yes. I wonder what's behind it. Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out? A door to the sky? Now that's unusual.
Pato! Pato's sky, look!
Oh my! I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish.
Pato?
Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door!
Pato, there you are! Pocoyo is looking for you! Wait! Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him! Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again! Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him?
Pato?
Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear!
Thank you.
Now, Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo.
Ellie!
Hello, Ellie.
Pato, Pato!
Hooray! You found him! What's that, Ellie? You're working on something. What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi, Nina.
Having a picnic, I see. Mmm, and something smells good. Oh, cupcakes, Ellie. I bet you worked hard on them. They look marvelous. Well done. Oh dear, Ellie, and you worked so hard. No cupcakes today. What a pity. A machine that can take you backwards in time? Oh, so you can go back to before the cupcakes were smashed. Brilliant! But how's it work? Incredible! We've gone back in time a whole minute. Guys, aren't you forgetting something important? No, Pocoyo, the banana peel. We can't let Ellie slip on it again. She's coming! Hurry! Tuck in. You ate them all. Oh, I see. You'll just go back in time again and have a second helping. But, oh dear, where are we? Yee-haw! We're in the Old West. But it looks like Miss Ellie isn't making cupcakes. Ha
Well, I'd say that now we're in prehistoric times. Aha! The banana peel, of course. Last, you're back in the present, and just in time for the cupcakes. Oh dear, hard luck, guys. You're a bit late. No, wait, there's Ellie. And she made more cupcakes just for you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Oh, look! It's Pocoyo and Pato. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
What a lovely morning. And what fine balloons. Where are you two off to?
Ellie!
Ah, I see. You're off to show your balloons to Ellie. What fun.
Ellie!
Oh dear. Can anyone tell Pocoyo why Ellie isn't answering?
She's asleep.
Ellie's sleeping.
That's right, Pocoyo. It looks like Ellie is taking a nap. That's a wonderful idea, Pocoyo. What a nice surprise for her when she wakes up. Oh no! It's the balloons! Oh no! Ellie! Come back! The vamoosh, of course, good idea, Pocoyo. But where has Ellie got to?
Ellie!
Oh no, the balloons! Thank you. Oh, that was close. Yes, that's it. Oh, do hurry. Oh, please hurry. Hurry there. Quick, quick. Don't let her fall. Got a plan, have you, Pato? Yes, good work, Pato. But, oh, what now? Look where Ellie's heading. I don't think Pocoyo and Pato understand. Wait, can any of you tell them what Ellie is heading for?
The tree!
She's gonna hit the tree!
Sleepy bird! Sleepy bird! Perhaps it would be best if you left your nest just for a moment. You see, there's a rather large pink elephant riding on a skateboard heading this way. She's almost here! I think Ellie wants to know why you let her sleep so long. All right then. I suppose I should explain, Ellie. First you floated up in the sky, and then you parachuted down to Earth, and then you nearly fell, but you landed on a skateboard, and then... Oh well. At least you had a nice sleep, Ellie, and we had a great adventure. Hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, everybody. Are you going someplace? So, you're going to the amusement park. What fun! Oh, my. I guess you'll have to wait for the next bus. Here it is. Well, don't worry. There's still one more bus today. And here it comes. Oh. And that was the last bus. What a shame. No amusement park today. But maybe you can find something that's just as much fun. What do you have in mind, Nina?
Well done! That was great! What's next, Pocoyo? What fun! But it looks like Pato isn't feeling so well. Now it's Ellie's turn! Awesome! You've made an obstacle course to play on! Don't worry! You can do it! Pato wants to show you his idea for a new ride. Roberto, I think Pato needs some help. Be careful! You're flying too high! Congratulations, guys! With a little imagination, you've got your own amusement park at home! Bye-bye, everyone! Hello, everyone! All dressed up for Halloween, I see. Hello, Nina. And where's your costume? You don't know what Halloween is? Well, Halloween is a special night where everyone has fun trying to scare each other. See? A scary, mad mummy! A frightening wolf man! And a spooky ghost pirate. What's that, Pato? You're going to tell a scary story? All right, Pato, let's hear it.
Once upon a time, there was an old pirate. He roamed the darkest dark ocean, carrying a trunk that was full to the brim with yummy candies. Suddenly, from out of the scary fog, a ghost ship The ghost pirate sent a giant octopus to steal the trunk. Turning all the candies into really terrifying ghost candies. Oh well, I suppose that wasn't so scary, was it? Pocoyo, would you like to try?
Yes!
Once upon a time, there was an ordinary boy who, when the moon was full, became the terrible, hair-raising, unbearable wolf boy. Well, the wolf boy just wants to play fetch. Ellie, would you like to try? There once was a mummy who went to the cemetery one dark and stormy night to have a lovely picnic with her dolls. And when a strange and haunting music started to play, they all had a zombie dance party! Well, Nina definitely isn't scared by that. Oh my! Who can that be? Trick or treat! Now that was a good scare! Happy Halloween! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
You
Can anyone tell me what Pocoyo is playing with?
Blocks!
No. I think what Pocoyo is playing with are... Oh, my. Well, yes, they are blocks after all. Well, blocks are fun to play with too. Very good! Look, everyone! Hasn't Pocoyo built a lovely tall...
Clock!
What? That's odd. Where'd that clock come from? That's a great idea. A nice nap in the cool shadow of a magnificent leafy
tree.
It all looks very tasty, Pocoyo. Perhaps a snack will do. So, are you going to make a sandwich? Good idea. First, he starts with a slice of...
Bread!
Next, a slice of...
Cheese!
Oh, yummy, Pocoyo! You've made a delicious...
Bunzo!
Well, that's nice. If you can't eat your sandwich, at least you can play the banjo.
Slide.
Yes, there's nothing more fun than playing on a... I agree, Pocoyo. Let's get to the bottom of this mess.
Bye!
Oh, now I understand. Nina is playing magic words.
Party.
Oh, very good, Pocoyo. A party. Something's missing.
Bread.
Hi, Pato. You're looking sharp. Have you got a new job? Oh, I see. You've become an outer space postman. How exciting. And you've got an assistant. Who is this package for, Pato? Ah, to Green Alien. And it's a rush delivery? Well, you'd better get going. You wouldn't want your first package to be delivered late. And we have liftoff! According to the address, Green Alien's house should be around here somewhere. Yep, here it is. Pato? I don't think that's him. Oh, I see. He says that Green Alien has moved and he doesn't live here anymore. But he would be happy to give you his new address. Well, according to this new address, Green Alien should be living right here. I'm afraid this is the wrong address. But no worries, the Toridoris know where he is. Looks like there's no one on this planet. I'm so sorry, Mr. Basketball. He says Green Alien's not here either, Pato, but that this is his new address. Green Alien! At last you've found him! He's wondering what took you so long. The Vamoosh is out of fuel. The power of the sun will take you back home. Welcome home! Good job! Quite right. Baby Bird deserves some credit too. Hooray for Baby Bird!
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Ooh, what are you doing? Oh, that's wonderful, Pocoyo. Can any of you tell what Pocoyo is drawing?
It's a fish.
A picture of a fish.
Exactly, it's a fish. A green fish. And what a beautiful green fish it is. What are you thinking about now, Pocoyo?
More picture.
Oh, I know. How about a nice place for the fish to live? Hi, Pato. Have you seen what Pocoyo's drawing? What's wrong, Pato? Look at that! Can any of you see where that fish is?
It's in the sky!
Yes, it's a fish in the sky! How imaginative, Pocoyo! I don't think Pato has seen a fish that lives in the sky before. It must be a birdfish, a bish, or a fish bird, or a third. Oh, never mind. What are you going to draw next, Pocoyo? A lovely blue fish. That's really very nice, Pocoyo. Oh, now, I wonder who that could be. I think Pocoyo wants to surprise you, Ellie.
Ta-da!
Look at that! Can any of you see where this fish lives?
In the trees!
Well, that's wonderfully imaginative too, Pocoyo. Look at that fish go! It's quite the swinger, isn't it? Oh dear, I don't think Ellie has seen a fish that lives in the forest before.
Another picture.
You're going to draw another picture, Pocoyo? I wonder what it's going to be this time. This is really fun. Oh, what a fantastic red fish. Well, I wonder where the red fish will live. Look at that! Can any of you see where this lovely red fish lives?
In the sea!
Yes, it's under the water in the sea. Oh yes, I suppose that drawing does show where fish really live. Wow! My goodness! Oh, I think Pocoyo is trying to tell you that he made those pictures for you, Pato and Ellie. I suppose it just goes to show it's lots of fun when you use your imagination. What's this? A gift for all of us? Why, thank you, Pocoyo. It's lovely. Hooray for Pocoyo and his lovely pictures. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
But what's that you're doing? Following somebody's trails? I wonder who left those footprints. They're rather small. I think I know. They are exactly the same size as Pocoyo's feet. Can anyone help Pocoyo guess who made those footprints?
Pocoyo!
It's Pocoyo's feet.
They're quite right. Pocoyo, you're following your own footprints. But what's that? Look, there are more footprints. And whoever left them isn't wearing shoes at all. In fact, I think they've got little paws instead of feet. Who left those prints? Do you know, Pocoyo? Well, did you leave those prints, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo guess whose prints those are?
A dog!
It's Lula!
Why, you're right! It was Lula! You see, sometimes we leave tracks or prints behind us, like when we walk on sand at the beach. Now those are very mysterious. Who or what do you suppose left those?
Round.
Yes, they are round.
Big!
You're right. It's big, too. Much bigger than your footprint, Pocoyo. Big, round feet. I wonder who on earth it could be. Pocoyo, do you know who could be leaving these tracks? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who has been making these big, round tracks?
Ellie!
You're right! It's Pocoyo's good friend, Ellie. Hello, Ellie! You certainly do have big feet, Ellie. Now here's someone who's leaving some very interesting footprints. Hello, Pato. Going for a swim? What sort of prints are these?
Big!
Yes, whoever left these prints has great big feet, even bigger than Ellie's. And whoever it is has webbed feet. Whoever left those footprints, it certainly wasn't a boy, a dog or an elephant, was it, Pocoyo? So who could it be?
What's that?
Oh no, Pocoyo. I don't think it could be a monster. Pocoyo? Pocoyo? If you just take a look... Pocoyo, I know it looks as though the monster is very close by, but really, there's no need to panic. Look, Pato, that's strange, isn't it? The prints are right behind you. Can you see who left those scary-looking footprints, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo whose feet match these footprints?
Pato!
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 It was Pato all along, in his flippers, going for a swim. Hooray for Pocoyo! You solved the mystery of the great big monster. Good work. Bye-bye. See you soon. Ah, what a beautiful evening it is. The stars are all twinkling so brightly. If you listen very carefully, you can just hear them. Do you see what I mean? Yes. And everyone is just settling down to bed. Lula and Pato. And look, there's Pocoyo and Ellie. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Hello.
It looks like they're just about to go to sleep too, listening to the sweet twinkling of... Oh dear, that doesn't sound good. Ah, Pocoyo, Ellie, do you know what that is? What about all of you? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie what that is?
Star.
Oh, that's lovely, Ellie. But you see, that star fell at... Yes, it's beautiful, isn't it, Ellie? But... That star belongs up in the sky. Look.
Star.
dear, Pocoyo. We'd better try and catch up with Ellie so we can explain to her about the star. There she is.
Ellie!
Ellie, wait! Oh, dear. Oh, good idea. I wonder if Pato's seen Ellie.
Pato! Ellie?
I wonder where Ellie is hiding. I don't think Pocoyo can see her. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Ellie is?
Up in the tree!
Aha, Ellie!
Oh, poor baby sleepy bird. What seems to be the matter? Can't you sleep? But what's wrong?
Oh.
I think little baby sleepy bird misses the twinkle, twinkle of the stars putting him to sleep at night. I think everyone's having trouble sleeping without the twinkle, twinkle of the stars, Ellie. I think Ellie would like one more moment with the star. Oh, thank you, Ellie. That was nice. How do we get it back up there? Oh, yes, the vamoosh. Perfect. Uh-oh! Watch out! There! Right where it belongs. Good job, everyone! And now, everyone in the world can enjoy the star along with you. Doesn't that feel good, Ellie? Ellie, and hooray for Pocoyo! Night night. See you soon. Look, it's Pocoyo and Lula. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
And hello, Lula. You two are having a good time, aren't you?
Lula. Stop. Boo.
What have you found?
Doki.
Yes, it's a toy dog. What's that on the dog's back? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that is on the dog's back?
A key!
A key!
Yes, that's right, a key. That must be a wind-up toy. Yes, Pocoyo, turning the key is a great idea. Keep turning. That's it. Now, set the dog down. Look at that. It barks too! Isn't that clever?
Oh, silly!
I think Lula wants to play, Pocoyo. I think it needs winding up. That is a very good trick, isn't it? Oh, look! Lula's doing some tricks for you too, Pocoyo. Lula, that's a clever trick as well. Oh well, never mind, Lula. Pocoyo, I think someone is feeling sad. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's feeling sad?
Lula's sad!
Poor Lula!
Well, you were busy playing with your new toy, and I think she felt a little left out.
Lula. Lula. Lula, play.
There, that's better.
Wow.
Don't worry, Lula. Pocoyo loves you much more than he loves his toy puppy. Well, now, that looks like fun. Sometimes you just need to pay a bit of attention to the puppies and people around you, and everyone has fun. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for Lula! Bye-bye. See you soon. Ah, there's Pocoyo. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, what lovely toys and what lovely colours they are. What is it, Pocoyo? Do you see something else? Oh my goodness, what is that you found, Pocoyo? That looks interesting.
Buttons!
Yes, why not? Give it a go. Press a button. Let's see what happens. Look at that! Your train has turned red. Look at that! Oh, I wonder what is making the colours change. Do you know, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo? What do you think he's doing to make things change colour?
Pressing the buttons!
Yes, I think you're right. When Pocoyo presses the buttons on that toy, the colours change. Ooh, try pressing a different button, Pocoyo. Yes, it is the toy. It changes the colours of things. Amazing. All the blocks have turned red.
Yay!
And a new colour for the radio. Wow! Careful, Pato. Oh dear. Pocoyo? Pocoyo? Are you having fun changing colours?
Yes.
And do you think everyone else is having fun too? Really? Would you like to turn things back to normal, Pocoyo? Well, I'm sure we can do that. We just need to remember what everyone's proper colour is. Can any of you help Pocoyo? Why don't you shout out when Pocoyo gets it right? Go ahead, Pocoyo. Try out some colours. First, what colour is Pato? Pink?
No.
Blue?
No.
Yellow?
That's it!
Pato's yellow!
Yes, and let's see who else. Oh, yes, Ellie. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what colour Ellie ought to be? Is it yellow?
No.
Blue?
No!
Pink!
She's pink!
Yes, she's pink, of course. Whew, I think that just about does it. What is it, Pato? What's wrong? Oh dear, Pato's hat still isn't the right colour. Do you see, Pocoyo? Great work, Pocoyo, and great work, everyone. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye, see you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oh, blocks. Good day for building up and up. And there are some more blocks. Did you see that? Maybe it was nothing. Okay, I definitely saw something that time. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what happened when he hummed?
The blocks moved!
My goodness, look at those blocks move! Well, I have to say, these are not normal blocks. They really love the music, don't they? These blocks are so funky, they really can move, can't they? And when it goes quiet, they all stop moving again. Oh, what a great idea! Let's see what happens when we play different types of music. Rock and roll, oh yes! Ooh, jazz music. That's my favourite, Pocoyo. Ah, classical music. Such an impressive sound. Pocoyo, Pato is, well... Pocoyo, you need to help get Pato down! He's stuck on top of the blocks! Pocoyo, are you really sure you should be doing that? Do you remember what will happen if the music stops, Pocoyo? Can any of you help, Pocoyo? Do you remember what happens when the music stops?
The blocks fall!
They all fall down!
Yes, and if the blocks fall, Pato falls with them! Pocoyo, quick! How can you get up there to save Pato?
Mm-hmm.
Of course! The Vamoosh is here to save the day! Pocoyo, bravo! Well, that was some adventure. Music certainly is wonderful, isn't it? Hooray for music! And hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon. Why, hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Wait a moment. Are you going to paint a picture? Oh, wonderful. Oh, but Pocoyo, what are you going to paint a picture of today?
Friends.
What a wonderful idea. Painting pictures of your friends. Who will you paint? Do you see anyone nearby? Can any of you help Pocoyo? Who do you think he should paint?
Paint Lula!
Lula! What a terrific idea! I'm sure Lula will make a perfect model.
Don't move!
Ah, that's the perfect color for Lula.
Lula, Lula!
Well, never mind, Pocoyo. You could always paint another one of your friends.
Pocoyo, paint Ellie!
Oh, I say, Ellie, you do look pretty for your painting. Ellie's too excited to have her portrait painted today, Pocoyo. But there must be someone else you could paint.
Bob. Pocoyo paints puzzle.
That's an interesting pose. Well, this is going to be an extraordinary painting. Oh, no! Oh, poor Pato. He did try to keep still for you, Pocoyo. Pocoyo? Where are you going? What's the matter? Oh, I see. You're not happy with the way things have worked out. But, Pocoyo, let us have a look at your painting.
No!
Oh, come on, Pocoyo. Just a little peek.
No!
Maybe all of you can help. Will you ask Pocoyo if we can see his painting? Maybe if you really, really want to see it, he'll show it to us. Go ahead and ask him.
Let us see the picture,
please.
Why, it's wonderful, Pocoyo. Look at it. You can see orange for Lula, pink for Ellie, and an amazing Pato shape for Pato. See? You see, Pocoyo? You really are a wonderful artist, and your friends are lucky to have such a beautiful painting. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon. There's Pocoyo, Pato, and Ellie. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Ah, it's a dressing-up box. So, what do you think you'd like to do today? Do any of you know?
Dressing up!
Dressing up!
Ah, yes! What a good idea!
Story, story!
What's that? You would like me to tell a story? And you will all pretend to be the characters? Oh, that would be great fun! And I think it's safe to say that, I'm rather a good storyteller. You all get ready now. Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lived a brave young prince. Oh, dear. Wait. The prince is the one who has a crown. Can any of you tell me which one of our friends is the prince? Yes, it's Pocoyo. Sorry, boys. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. Now, this young prince was called Prince Pocoyo.
Hooray!
And he was very brave. And very handsome. And strong. Oh, and tall, of course, yes. But this prince wasn't alone in his kingdom. Oh, no. There was also a beautiful elephant princess who had... No birds. Thank you, baby bird. Thank you. Anyway, she was without doubt the sweetest and most charming creature in the universe. So dainty and beautiful and strong. Yes, well, that's very impressive, Ellie. must say, this isn't quite the story I was expecting to tell. But I think a weightlifting princess will work out very well indeed. Now, where were we? Ah, yes, yes. This delicate and dainty elephant princess loved the prince. And the prince loved her. Ah, this isn't going so badly after all. But she was desperately sad because she couldn't go out to play with Prince Pocoyo because a crazy duck would not let her.
Boo.
He was a cruel and crazy... Ah, come on. Oh, do come on, Pato. You're supposed to be the baddie. Look, I promise you, you can be the prince next time, all right? Please? I promise. Good. So, this crazy duck was really cruel and crazy. More crazy? Just a little bit more crazy, Pato. Ah, that's perfect. Thank you, Pato. So, when he saw the young prince approaching, he decided to frighten him away forever with his fierce, terrifying, fire-breathing dragon. Yes! Who jumped towards the prince and started to kiss him. Oh, dear. After this, the crazy duck was so furious, he sent his best warrior, the Sleeping Knight, and his terrible army. Hello again, baby bird. This time, Prince Pocoyo was surrounded. No escape. What could he do? Invite them all to a picnic? Why did I ask? And to have a little sleep in his bed? But Crazy Duck was really angry with him, so angry that he started to water his plants. And the elephant princess went for a ride on her scooter. Ellie, Ellie! But this is not a... And Prince Pocoyo played in his car, and the crazy duck bought himself a canary, and... Oh, wait a moment. Now I get it. Yes! Once upon a time, there were some great friends who just love playing together. What a wonderful story. Hooray for stories and hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon.